Hello, World of Tank Blitzers. It's Littlefinger here today with a full tank review on the Nashorn. Yes, you can see this in the garage as a German Tier 6 tank destroyer. And I really enjoyed playing this. I don't know if it was the fact that I played these when they first came out and they have buffed them in the interim. I don't know, but I was really expecting a horrible, horrible tank coming back to this. But I tell you what, I had some really fun, exciting games in this tank. So anyway, let's jump real quick into the tech tree here. And I'll show you where we're at the top here on the list. You've just come from the toaster there. Struggle through it, and now you've just purchased the Nashorn, and really where you want to get to is these tier 8 through tier 10 tanks. The Stura Meal is going to be another difficult tank to play, but once we get up to the RHM, the Waffenträger, and the Grill, we're going to have these amazing guns on these light, fast-moving tanks, and even have a rotational turret. Believe me, the wait is worth it, so keep on grinding away. Hopefully you'll learn some tips and tricks on making yourself a better player in this tank. Obviously, the biggest thing with it is no armor, but the gun is amazing, and it's really got good speed and mobility. So with that in mind, I just want to point out, running 24 rounds of AP, 10 rounds of APCR, really, really don't need this except for some really heavy tier 7 tanks and HE. Not going to use it a whole lot because your pen's not great with this gun. But equipment, I am running the gun rammer, the defense system, and of course camouflage net with a tank destroyer. No need to worry about spending your credits on these level 2 or level 3 in my opinion. But I would probably go, you just don't need this on this tank really. I might spend some credits on just making the tank a little bit faster. Obviously your armor's not going to do anything, so you're only going to get an additional 60 hit points. I just don't think it's worth spending your credits there. Let's just take a quick look at this tank. You're going to want to grind your way up to this 8.8. I just can't talk enough about how good this gun is. A pen on it, 203. You're doing 220 damage. You've got 11 rounds per minute with this setup. So, obviously, you're going to struggle a little bit. It's 110 horsepower lower than where we're at here at 385. So, when you first get the tank, it's going to be a little sluggish. But believe me, when you get the updated tracks and updated engine on this, this thing really moves around the battlefield well. Really, the second gun on here is certainly serviceable at 145. You will need a little bit more APCR, and you can grind your way up to the L71. All right, guys, here we are on blitzstars.com. I've got tank compare pulled up, Nashorn on the left, the rest of the tier 6 TDs, non-premium to the right. And just looking without equipment, damage per minute, 2351, penetration 203. We're just blowing these other tanks out of the water with this penetration outside of the gun carrier, 20% more. So this allows us to run the gun rammer, which is going to get our DPM up to 2528. Also note shell velocity 1,000 and how much better that is than all of these other tanks. This gun on this tank will not disappoint you. You can see 1.72 on the aim time is really good. The dispersion there, 0.29. It's accurate. That's all I can say. It is super accurate. We've got negative 8 degrees of gun depression, so you can play this on hills, which is highly recommended because you've got no armor. So really want to use that so you can protect yourself when you're not shooting. As far as mobility goes, 45 kilometers per hour. It's a very mobile tank. It fits in nicely with these other tanks. You compare it to the gun carrier, which is only 26 kilometers per hour. So it does manage to get its way around the battlefield pretty good, even with a terrain resistance of only 1.0, which is going to allow you to accelerate pretty quickly. Also note, we've got a 112% on the credit coefficient, so you're going to make some decent money in this tank, provided you can stay alive long enough to dish out some damage. And so we're going to jump into some gameplay and show you how to do that. All right, guys, so here we are, first game on Middleburg. And just really, really, really want you to focus when you're playing this tank to try to stay on the edge of the map, if at all possible. You want to make sure that you stay hidden, unspotted, for as long as possible. Conserve those hit points, and then use your speed and this fast-firing gun to trade shots at the end. Almost like you would if you were in a light or even medium tank. But you can see in this game here, they have pushed so fast through the middle. So I'm going to take a little bit of a risk here. Get one shot into that KV-1S and then back down the hill. I've got this Cromwell coming at me. And one of the things I want you to point out is just how well this tank traverses. I mean, here is a fast medium tank. Although I missed that shot, I am keeping up with his turning radius there, and we managed to basically get out with just taking two shots from him. We gave him two shots back and missed one, unfortunately. But this does draw me back down the hill to this KV-2. And not quite able to get up over that ridgeline to get the shot. We've got that jumbo there. So we're going to go ahead and start just pumping out shots into him. And you can see how fast this tank just reloads. And just the accuracy on each and every one of these shots here. The Leo starts shooting me. And I still managed to get that shot in. So we're going to pull back now. And I'm glad we did here, because they're going to have some tanks pop around the corner. There's that KV-2. We want to make sure we are out of his sight. That is probably the scariest tank you're going to see in this thing with zero armor. But they take out our KV-2. And now it's just me down here against these three tanks. So this Leo has gotten brave here. And he's going to rush in. And I'm not sure if he's on the reload here. But you can see we knock him out two shots there. And I really don't take much damage for him. Now it's the other Leo's turn. And he's just going to sit right in front of us as we pop that first shot in. He gets basically a full clip in there, but we're able to finish him off before he can run away. KV-2 down here at the bottom really hasn't moved. I'm seeing him looking at me, so I'm not going to make a mistake of coming around this corner. Now he's focused, can turn, get my shot, and you see how that aim time is just amazing. Hardly have to wait. Now, I've got a choice to make. It's 2-on-2. KV-2 just shot. He's obviously on a long reload, but he's behind that building. And I'm not sure if I can get there in time to get two shots off to finish him. So I'm going to decide to put distance between him and come up the hill and really, really hope that our M4 there had the SU-100Y pinned down and was able to finish him off. Which he did. But now it's a matter of relocating this KV-2 and putting myself in a situation where I can take a shot and I can hide. Obviously, not very easy, but I'm on hills. So I'm thinking I can, if I can find the right hill here, I can get a shot in. And at 460, he should be a two-shot to me, doing about 220 damage, 240 damage. So it's going to be pretty close. So now I've found myself on a rather steep hill, and I don't have the gun depression. If I pull all the way up, you can see there, he's going to have that shot. We both missed. So long reload here. Great aim time on this tank. Let me snap that one in. 216, it's going to be two shots. Two more shots, that is. So I'm rushing around the corner hoping to get this one in. And can I get the last one in? We're at 3,000 damage already. Kill number three. There it is. 3,065 damage. So that fast-firing, accurate gun with really good penetration saved the day, really. And that was a mastery in this tank. Seventeen shots, and all of them went in. I did miss a couple on that KV, but So here's second game on Dead Rail, supremacy game here. And just like in that first game, I'm going to try to stay on the outside as much as possible in this tank. Obviously, that's what TDs primarily do. You know, you're going to get that camo net engaged and you're just going to snipe away. But it's really critical with this tank, with not having any armor. So other team has gone C. I'm just going to throw a couple quick shots in there, hoping to get lucky. And watching my other team move on, so I don't want to get left behind. And as they're doing that, I'm still in a high enough place that I can go ahead and take some shots there. That SU-100Y, just snap that in, but missed. Kuro going up the hill. You know, this is 400 meters away, and you can see we don't really even have to time that aim. Just with the speed of these shells, it really gets there in a hurry. You can see we took that one without the SU-100Y even being spotted. And we're going to get, looks like, three shots into him before, you know, he can even turn around. So, really, really loving the gun, the accuracy on this tank. And we've got two of their guys. We've got one base to their two. So, not a lot of pressure just yet, but want to go ahead and move forward and make sure we're getting shots in on them. And this nice subtle hill here gives me a nice spot to get up and try to work some shots over this ridgeline. T-34 is in trouble. Go ahead and finish him off. I'm spotted now, so we're definitely going to back down. And sure enough, I've got a tank behind me, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to rush forward. We're going to set that Tiger on fire. Nice damage there. And he's finished off. And so what this allows me to do is then get behind this building. Obviously, you don't want tanks really anywhere around you, certainly not behind you. So we're just basically in a situation where we've got to trade shots. Unfortunately, we track him there. And get one more shot while he's on the reload. And he's finished off. So it was really just the J Panther left. And you can see he's snapping these shots in, hardly having to aim at all. Just a little bit high on that one. He's only giving us a little bit of a sliver. Waiting, being patient. Look at that. Snap that in there. And we're actually going to get the kill shot here and finish him off. 2,000, almost 2,500 damage here. Three kills, just from a really good sniping spot. So you can see just the accuracy of this gun and how it can dish out the damage. But remember, we're staying on the edge of the map. We're not getting ourselves in trouble early in the game. So this is a clip from Alpinestadt, and I just want to show you this. As an example of being too aggressive and putting myself in a really bad situation. You can see KV-2, SU-100Y, and HTC all coming at me. And basically, I'm just going to sit here in this ditch and try to stay alive as long as I can and see if my team can't help me out. That KV-2's just been taking a shot, taking out our KV-2, and here comes the T-28 HTC. And you can see here, I'm in a bad situation. He gets that first shot in, and I realize, you know, we're two TDs, and I'm just going to try to get around him and see if we can't play this one out. Obviously, my team has distracted the enemy Reds, because I'm just sitting here on top of this hill now, completely exposed, and what I'm going to do is just get him to back up into this building, and we can just get turned enough. We'll get one shot in. He's gonna get a shot in here when I back up, but hopefully we can reload and we finish him off. 100% destruction on a tier higher tank. Now, I'm not recommending brawling in this tank, but just want to point that out as getting yourself into trouble in the middle of a map, but with this high rate of fire damage per minute, you can battle your way out of some hairy situations at times. Alright, so in this game, we are top tier again on Mirage. Our team calls Beach, and you know, I'm perfectly fine with that. Obviously, anything over that railroad track, I can get some nice gun depression and take my shots and back down. But for whatever reason, some of our guys don't know where the beach is, maybe. I don't know. You know, it's just one of those things that's frustrating with this game sometimes. You try your hardest to get people to follow. They just don't listen. T-150 over there, if he'd have just gotten one or two shots in, this game would have been completely different. Obviously, we had one nub that rushed into their team, died. Meanwhile, those of us that went beach have noticed this Nashorn is obviously their weak link at this time. So, again, still trying to stay. There's the T-150, lost noob team, yeah. And the guy that gets zero damage is the one that complains the most. So we finished off the Nashorn here. And team is just spread out all over the place. So I really think the best thing for me to do is to work my way back towards the KV-2 here. We've got one guy on the hill that's completely surrounded. He's not going to last much longer. And here's the KV-2. He has a horrible game, too. I just really want him just to back up and get that Leo in my line of sight. Finally does here, so we get our first shot in. Leo shooting. KV-2 hasn't done anything, and we finish off the enemy red Leo. Still manageable here. It's 3-on-5, but for whatever reason, this Leo, our Leo, decides, you know, he's going to run on into the middle of five tanks. Again, you can't always have the smartest teams. You can try to your best and just do as much damage as you can. So, anyway, the VK and the T-34 have spotted up over here close to cap. And so I get one shot in, trade with the VK. We'll trade again and finish him off. Now we're looking a little better. It's 4-on-3, but this Leo has way overextended. I make a mistake here of not taking a wide angle over this hill. And I would have liked to have gotten a snapshot on that KV-2, which would have allowed me to reload and proceed with these shots here. And finish him off. But as you can see, what ends up happening is I get three shots in and leave him as a one shot, and he's gonna do a real good job of basically leaving me with not much of a decision, and I'm kind of just waiting for him to make a mistake. KV-2, I'm hoping he can get one more big shot in, but that's not gonna happen either. And you can see I was hoping that KV-2 would peek over. It's 4-on-1 now, so not much I can do. Might as well just take my chances with the KV-2, and we're going to swing around, take our shot, and he's going to miss. T-34 is going to try to get around us, which we know with this tank is not an easy thing to do, even with him coming down the hill full speed. Unfortunately, I would have liked to try to run away from these guys, but with this Churchill coming up over the hill, and there's the Type 58, you know, I really just can't get away. Limited here, obviously, with the turret not being able to swing around, and we do get finished off there. We end up with 5 kills, 2237 damage, and basically tried to work the situation the best we could there. So here's a bottom tier game on Alpine Stud, and as I've been preaching in this video, trying to stay on the outside of the map, you'll see I'm going to go ahead and basically just follow the red line to my right and up on the hill here. Away we go. Just trying to stay as close to this red line as possible. Dicker Max. It's actually got some fairly decent frontal armor, and yet you can see here we are just gonna pump shots in here. Now, that didn't hit the bridge behind it, so we know it hit. I'm going to go ahead and take another one. Again, doesn't hit the bridge behind it, so we get spotted, switch over to HE on the Nashorn, take our shot, and get out of Dodge, as we have now taken two shots up there. And the thing I like about this tank is its speed. So we're up a tank, supremacy, no one's captured a base. Everybody's fighting in that general area, and so I make a decision here with my speed. I'm going to go cap C. In hindsight, maybe going to B and getting some halfway flanking shots in there might have been better. But, you know, that's the funny thing with the supremacy. We've got A already. If we can get C and just hold on long enough, we've got a much greater chance of winning this game. Now, I think by going C, I get some attention from their mediums, which in of itself is probably a good thing because we've drawn a couple tanks off of the main battalion there. And, you know, while I don't survive, obviously a two-on-one situation coming up here, it does allow my team to close in, and we do end up winning this game. It's a difficult situation here with this Fury being this fast. And unfortunately, I missed that shot. Shoot a little bit too early, but you can see I've got two tanks on me now. It's 4-on-4, but obviously only two tanks in the other area, and so they were able to clear them and clear the other two. But we ended up here as the second highest damage. And you know, just a very short amount of time with this tank. So, again, supremacy is a little bit different. I'm starting to like it a little bit more, though. So this is the last game here on Canal, and really just wanted to show this really nice little sniping spot. I'm sure a lot of you know it, but in supremacy, obviously you get a lot of people from that north spawn going straight into B. And so what I like to do is climb up on this ridgeline here and just make sure that I've got shots down the side of this building into B here and kind of prevent them from capping. But since this is sped up, it's a little bit faster than normal. But they've gone to A, and you can see you've even got shots in on A from here. And we're going to get a shot in on that Hellcat. And that's one of the things with this tank and this speed of this shell is it's really easy to aim long distance. Cromwell gets shots up on him on top of that hill there. And, you know, we've just put a hurting on these guys. Now I see that Cap A is moving forward, so at least one guy here. Gonna try to position myself so that I can get my camo engaged here. And there's camo net, and there's four shots into this guy before he really even sees me. I'm actually a little bit faster turning radius than that AMX there, and he gets away. But we're gonna chase him down, get a shot in here. And then one more to finish him off. So, you know, I'll start just going into my summary on this tank. You can see I really tried to do as good a job as I could about staying on the back line and away from these big heavy tanks, these KV-2s, taking any type of derp shot. And I think you can do that with this tank because of its maneuverability and its speed. And I think that's probably why I enjoyed it a little bit more playing it this second go-round. I was just able to basically keep myself in the game longer on most of these games that I played. I don't think I really had a game more than less than 800 damage. Some of, you know, 3,000 as the top there. So I felt like it was a really good tank. It is obviously difficult to play. You can't brawl. Limited with the turret. All those other things with the standard TD, but really thought that this was a tank that, you know, you can get behind and grind up to the starter meal and then get yourself up to these the really good tier 8 through tier 10 TDs on this German line. So anyway, guys, hope you learned a few things, and if you're not already subscribed, please do so. Would like love to get contributor status with Wargaming and try out all of these tanks. Need quite a few more subscribers in order to do that. So anyway, As always, hope you're having fun out there. Stay safe and get educated, not fingered. Littlefinger out.